when Pearl Harbor broke out, you know, on December 7th, on the December 8th, I skipped school and ran down to the recruiting office and, or went by trolley down to the recruiting office in Minneapolis. And I got the papers and everything, but my, when I came home with them, my parents wouldn't sign them because I was only 17. So when I reached my 18th birthday in August, after football, season was over with, why I went down to Minneapolis and enlisted in the Marine Corps.
Richard K. Sorenson trained at Camp Pendleton with the 4th Marine Division. In January 1944, the unit shipped out to combat in the Marshall Islands. The 19-year-old private was assigned to a machine gun crew, none of whom had ever experienced combat. On the morning of February 1st, the unit landed on the tiny island of Namur, which was defended by a force of 4,000 Japanese soldiers.
We hit the beach at 12 noon, exactly, quite heavy fire. The Japanese were great at hiding, and they would crawl under debris and so forth, and then when we passed through, they'd come up behind us and start shooting at the reserves. We just kept moving ahead as fast as we could to keep the enemy unsettled. We fought our way about three quarters of the way across the island. About an hour after, or 2 hours after we hit the beach, on our right flank, the 1st Battalion come across a large blockhouse. And so they set satchel charges against it to blow a hole in it, and then they threw another satchel charge inside. A lot of Japanese ran out the other end. They didn't know it at the time, but it was loaded with torpedo warheads and aerial bombs. And it went up and covered the whole island with dust and dirt and black smoke. And the concrete from that blockhouse even landed out in the, on the ships out in the bay there. And the only thing left of it was a large hole. A lot of people were injured, and we suffered a lot of casualties. The battalion commander passed the word to pull back to so that they could straighten up the line so that no flanks were exposed. But I was with a group of about 30, and we didn't get the word. But we settled in for the night in what was the remains of a destroyed building and had the footings all around it, and so we set up a perimeter for the night. And of course the Navy kept throwing up these flares to keep the island lit up so the Japanese, if they started a counterattack or tried to infiltrate, we could pick them out. So we didn't get any rest at all during the night. Dawn came and the sun came up, and then the Japanese launched their last attack. They didn't know we were there until we started opening fire. We were completely surrounded. We felt like General Custer and his group. We fought for about an hour, and our troops did not know we were up there, and so they were throwing in mortar shells and grenades, a lot of fire. We only had one light machine gun left. Our heavy had been knocked out. Our gunner and assistant gunner killed. And then somebody yelled grenade, and I looked down, saw it, so I fell on it. I laid there about an hour, and a corpsman named Kirby crawled over and tied off an artery, or I'd have bled to death. It took about an hour, hour and a half, I guess, before our people were able to push through and relieve us. By that time, there was 18 wounded in our group. Somebody had to do it, and it just happened to be me.
Months later, while convalescing at Seattle Naval Hospital, Richard Sorenson learned that his actions had earned him the Medal of Honor.
They turned out all the nurses and doctors, turned out the whole hospital. General Fagan, who was commanding general of the Fleet Marine Force Pacific, presented me with a medal. That was quite a thrill. It wasn't something that was planned. It just happened. And I could have avoided it, but you got very close to the fellows. And a lot of comradeship there. And it was, it bothered you when the fellows got killed. You don't pay any attention to the gunfire or anything. It's just, you know what you gotta do and you're gonna do it.